We've been condemning ISIS for, you know, years. And even prior to ISIS, we've condemned bin Laden and anyone who has promoted the massacre of innocent women and children. This can never be considered a part of any religion, to murder innocent civilians, women and children.
All right, well, obviously there has been this... this labeling of Trinidad being one of the places that we export ISIS fighters. That has been, there have been reporters or reports from varying parts of the world that Trinidad is one of the sources or the places that they recruit fighters to for the ISIS. Tell us about that. Is that a, is that truth? Is there any proof to that, or is it just misconception?
I mean, the thing about it, you know, extremists and deviants, they exist in many communities. And their message, whenever they appear, needs to be countered by qualified people. I mean, one thing the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, he said that there will appear extremists. And he warned against it clearly in many prophetic traditions. One tradition, he said, they are hudatha al-asnan, Sufah al-Ahlam. They're young in age and they have a foolish outlook. A foolish outlook as it relates to religion and also the world. So there may be people in Trinidad that go overseas. But I think what is important is when we look at the amount of Muslims in Trinidad and the percentage that are going overseas and joining these extreme and radical organizations. If, for example, we find that there are preachers present in Trinidad, like they may be present in other places, that their message is countered, it's challenged publicly, and that they are called out by their names. So, for example, if there was a particular community, a mosque, wherever they would be, you would find that, I'm sure, that Muslims would be very vocal in condemning the message that emanate from that mosque.
Would you, from your standpoint, Imam, do you condemn the ISIS situation?
No doubt. I mean, we've been condemning ISIS for... you know, years. Even prior to ISIS, we've condemned bin Laden and anyone who has promoted the massacre of innocent women and children. This can never be considered a part of any religion, to murder innocent civilians, women and children. No doubt about it, we've produced literature, leaflets, actually booklets, and we've actually spread them for free. The problem is, and one of the problems, and I, you know, I thank you for the opportunity to actually present a correct narrative, you know, to your audience, is that the media, when they want to talk about Islam, those who are irresponsible, who do they invite? They invite people who are reckless and don't represent the Muslim community. Okay. People who are going to say things that are going to be alarming and are going to give, for example, a picture that, yes, you know, Muslims are extreme. And in reality, they don't represent no one except themselves.